So we just wrapped our Trunk or Treat event last Wednesday here at the church. It's probably one of the most successful ones that we have done here. And you probably have a pretty similar event. And it always seems like the worship pastor is the one that is in charge of pulling together the PA and selecting a playlist of songs to play at the event. And I wanted to show you how we were able to play music all over the event, all over the campus, instead of just at a centralized location at the stage without running a bunch of audio cables. Hi, I'm Dave Dolphin at practicalworshipblog.com, sharing ideas, tips, and practical advice for the everyday worship leader. And on this channel, we have weekly videos that help you lead a worship band and be a leader of people. So if you haven't already, consider subscribing so you don't miss the next one. I'm a huge proponent of vibe, how music and selecting the right songs can really set the tone for the entire event. And this year we had a different way of setting up all the gear that allowed that vibe to permeate all throughout the event instead of being centralized to just one place where the stage is. And I think that it worked so well that last Wednesday I took up my phone and I just started to document it.
Well, welcome to our Trunk or Treat. We got all the things, we got all the cars lined up and all the people, a little bit of rain, but that won't hurt anybody. We got the inflatables over here. And even got like these little go-kart looking things that people can ride. So, I mean, pretty fun. One of the things that really makes a really good event just really happen is vibe, as far as the music that you play and being real selective about what kind of mood that sets and just kind of creating an atmosphere, creating a vibe for the event. Now, normally what you do in an event like this is you have a stage, kind of like the one that I have behind me next to that tent. And so at the stage, you know, you set up a couple of speakers in the center of the event and then you shoot the speakers out. And that's how most people try to create vibe. But we've done something different because we've got a speaker right over there. We got a speaker over on the other corner, right over by the inflatables and the bathrooms. And then over by the food trucks, we got one over here as well. So essentially what we're doing is instead of having a couple of speakers in the middle of the event and shooting it out, we are actually, we've positioned speakers on the exterior of the event and we're shooting it in. But here's the thing, because the first question is, how do you run cables? The answer is you don't. So here is just inside the gym, and this is Cameron. Everyone say hi to Cameron. He is our media director here at the church, and my number two. And so, Cameron, show me how we're getting a vibe out into the event.
All right, so we've got a huge, huge thing going on, speakers all over the place. What you're gonna see here is essentially what you'd expect. We've got an iPad, you know, just running tunes into this little mixer that we're sending out. And the trick, the magic, comes from this guy right here. So that's our little FM transmitter. And we're using that to broadcast out. Each one of our speakers has this tiny little just FM radio that we have attached on each one of them, plugged in. So everything's going out through that. So all we have to do is think about power, which is really convenient because we already have these big light trees everywhere. And so, hey, let's just put a speaker next to those, plug them in, and then they're wirelessly getting the audio. So that's awesome.
Okay, so tell me what we're doing with this right here. Okay. This is ingenious.
All right, so this is just a compressor. With our setup being inside a building and our vent being outside of the building, it makes it really, really hard to know when to turn down and up the music with the speaker. So we're using the compressor as an auto ducker. We have the microphones plugged in as the trigger for the compressor. Our iPad is going in as just the source. And we're using, anytime somebody speaks in the microphone, it's gonna automatically compress the signal from the iPad using what the speaker is saying. And then that sends out and we just mix it from there like normal. And so it's a pretty hands-off approach to everything.
Now in hindsight, I wish that we would have spent the extra dollars to get a dedicated antenna, the larger antenna for the FM transmitter. But otherwise, I'm pretty impressed on how this little system works. All in all, we spent about $150 on the FM transmitter and all those FM radios. And the neat thing about this setup is that not only is it good for events like this, but it's also a great way to do a hearing assist system on a Sunday morning. You just connect the FM transmitter to your audio desk, and then you give someone an FM radio with some headphones, and now they have a better way to hear during the Sunday morning service. I'll put links to the equipment that we use in the description down below. I'm also gonna include a link to that Spotify playlist that we use. Like I said, music is a very powerful way to create vibe, and I'm pretty selective when it comes to the songs that you play and the order that you play them in. For more videos just like this one, consider subscribing to the channel. That way you're notified when new ones are uploaded every single week. And for more advice, for me personally, I have a small little ebook called 20 Things I Wish I Knew 20 Years Ago. It's the advice that I've learned over the last 20 years of doing music ministry, and you can download it right now for free at practicalworshipblog.com.